Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Well, here we are today in Minnesota, Jordan, Minnesota, I might add, at the KOA campground, and we've made it this far, and we're going to take you guys right along with us on this hayride. Everyone's getting loaded up here on the wagon, and we're going to go for a tour around the KOA campground here with Tom, the leader of the group here, and he's driving the rig, and we're going to show you what it's all about. So you guys hang tight, because I've got more coming from the RV Bandwagon right about now. Check this out. I'm going to start my park tour right here on our hayride, which we have every Saturday afternoon about 6 o'clock, weather permitting. The hayride here at KOA has been a staple of this park for many years. Tom, the owner of the park, has been the driver of the hayride for the last 7 years. The hayride lasts about 20 minutes long and takes campers all through the campground and around the campsites. Soon I will be taking over the driver's seat of the old tractor and pulling the hayride around the campground myself. And if you know my background in theatrical entertainment venues, you know I'll be putting my own twist on this ride. I may just have to incorporate some Star Wars characters around the old hayride. I think Chewbacca may really enjoy riding with our campers on the wagon. And can you imagine meeting up with some Imperial Stormtroopers along the way? And what about Darth Vader? Well, that's what I'm hoping for, but it all depends on our work camper situation. We're now looking for some work campers to help out with these types of venues, as well as keeping the park maintained and in shape for our campers. If you're an RVer interested in traveling to Minnesota for the summer, we do have some positions open for our work campers. In fact, I'm looking for 3 awesome work campers right now. Jordan, Minnesota is beautiful, the people are awesome, and the work is fun. This hayride is almost complete, but stay tuned because I'm going to tell you more about our work camp opportunities and show you a little bit more here at the park so you know what's going on. Well, guys, I'm Scott, the new manager here at Jordan KOA in Minnesota, and glad to be part of it, to tell you the truth, and looking forward to bringing some action from our KOA right your way through the YouTube channel here. We're going to show you the upgrades we're making, show you who signs on to be our work campers and what that's all about, and give you an inside scoop as to what it takes to make a KOA campground operate on a daily basis. There may be more to it than you think. Anyways, I think you're going to enjoy the ride whether you're just watching from home or you actually come in and become a work camper. A lot of fun to be had here, and it's a beautiful state and a lot of things going on in the area, including an awesome amusement park, Mall of America, and one of the biggest candy stores I've ever seen. Until next time, I am the RV Bandwagon, and make sure you guys stay tuned because I've got more coming at you right about now. Check this out.
I figured I'd take you on a nice e-bike ride around the park so you really get an idea of how big it is and what is really going on. This is the road you'll take to get into the park. Look off to the left-hand side and you'll see one of our group camp areas. When you enter the park, registration and check-in is actually over to the right-hand side. Right now, we're going to be going to the left and up and around the park. When you first enter the park, you'll notice a couple of our deluxe cabins. We have a total of 8 cabins on this property. The remaining 6 units are done in this log cabin style. As we go further into the park, you'll notice some of our deluxe pull-through sites. Many of our spaces can accommodate the larger size RVs. We're now making our way towards the back of the park where we can accommodate mid-size RVs, tents, and small camp trailers. The sites up here generally have a fire pit, electric, which is 30 amp, and water. Up ahead on the right is the larger of our two playgrounds and the volleyball area. As you can see, right now the park is quite empty, and that's because I'm recording on a Tuesday and the kids have not yet got out from school for the summer. During the weekends, this park is completely full, as it will be during the summer months. As we make our way further into the park, you'll notice to the right, four more log-style cabins. These four units are the smallest cabins we have on site. As we make our way further into the park, you'll notice more mid to small size sites on the left-hand side. And of course, dogs are always welcome. As we turn the corner to the right, we'll make our way back in front of the park, where we'll find the traditional A-frame check-in building that also doubles as our general store, and off to the right there you'll see the pool building. This is also the area where our campers will board the Saturday evening hayride. This big flat spot is where our campers come in with their RVs to check in. And up here on the right is another small road that will lead you to a few more campsites and the dump station. As we travel just a bit further, we'll go past our gravel pile and hang a left. That's the road you came in on. That's also the road we'll exit on. Welcome to the KOA out here in Minnesota. And I'm your host now. We're getting ready to take this place over tomorrow night at the strike of midnight. Wow. There's a lot to this park. It's not super huge. We got about 110 sites, give or take, depending on what day of the week it is. It's really a beautiful park. We've got several really good employees. I'm looking for a couple more if you want to be a work camper out there. And you're familiar with most anything that has to do with RVs and RV parks. Well, hit me up down in the comment section below, because I'm looking for about three really awesome work campers. We've got some awesome sites here for you, full hookups, and you'll get a paycheck. So, and it goes through October 15th, and then you're off to Never Never Land. But if you want to be a work camper, I would love to hear from you. Make sure you check it out right here on the RV Bandwagon, because I got more coming at you right about now. Check this out. As a work camper, you may stay a little busy, but you're going to have a lot of fun here. There's a lot of great people that come to this park, and that's what they come for, is to have a great time. They hang out for the weekend. Man, they bring every bit of their camping arsenal and just set out to have the best time, and that's what we want you to do, because it really rubs off. We have a lot going on. As you can see behind me, we have a nice playground set up, a lot of tent camping, a lot of dry camping, a lot of full hookups. We can accommodate big rigs, but we got little things that need to be touched up, like that pedestal. Paint helps everything, and that's what we're going to be needing your help with, is little things like that, touching up our cabin, getting them looking good, pressure washing, things like that. Nothing too crazy, but things that need to be done. And then the general daily stuff that we do is going around the park, making sure the campfire pits are cleaned out, everything's looking tidy, All the roads are done nicely. Yeah, just your basic things that you do at a campground to keep it going. Nothing too crazy. Nothing you need to know a ton about, because anything that we do out here, you certainly can learn in just a few minutes. It's really that simple. If you do have skills with the chainsaw, weed whackers, and mowers, that type of thing, that comes in handy. We do have a couple people already doing that, but you never know. So if you have any kind of skills and you're interested in camping out here in Jordan, Minnesota for, 4 or 5 months, we're going till October 15th. We have a big Halloween event at the end of the season to wrap it up, and that's a lot of fun, and we're going to make it even funner this year. But we invite you to come on out and be a part of the fun here at KOA and be a work camper. We need several of you. And like I said, you get a nice site. We have several of those for our work campers, full hookups. You get a paycheck, and you get a little security for the summertime of where you're gonna be, where you're gonna park, and what you're gonna do. All right, guys, I'm RV Bandwagon, also known as Scott. And I'm here now, the manager of KOA through the summer season. And I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys. We need your help. We need some work campers. Make sure you check it out right down here in the description box below, because we need your help. All right, guys? I showed you what it's about. Now it's up to you. Hit me up. I got more coming from the RV Bandwagon right about now. Check this out. It actually works, ladies and gentlemen. There's a dial tone on this phone. You don't see this around too often, so make sure you stop by the KOA and get a picture of you by the old telephone that actually works. Pretty amazing, right here, KOA in Minnesota.